meet a nigga and get hit.
Everybody put that Glock.
Like, that is so traumatizing. Like, what?
Shut shit up.
That is crazy.
You gotta stick on that shit. You gotta
after he hit you and found out that photo was your dad, explain what apologizing is for TKO.
Last out we caught was at the store, we had to scrape it. Lil bro hopped out tripping with that switchy, he didn't face it. They shot, they couldn't save him. We the ones getting busy up in the city, that's on my baby. They block like a drive through, ask the ops how much we slide through. Ain't beefing but you they family, you get caught then you gon' die too.
Hold on,
stop the whip, let me out this chopstick, gon' leave him open like a zip. Zip him up, tell buddy no mask to come and pick him up. Niggas faking, acting like they thug like till we hit him up. A lot of niggas don't like me, for what? I ain't even did shit. Make his bitch take dick to the head, I ain't even hit yet. How you mad she choosing me? I like what she do to me. She say she feel safer over here, this where the shooters be. She say ain't no paper up over there, shit she barely eating. Can barely feed herself, she told me help, this nigga barely feed me. We don't do the social tweet, these niggas too internet. Going live trying to talk about who got shot, we don't get into that. Can you leave it up in the streets for me? I ain't trying to go to jail. Keep mentioning my name in all of your posts, it ain't hard to tell. If you get smoked, they gon' come looking for me. Nigga, you dumb as hell. This bitch think I love her, ooh wee, she must be drunk as hell. I can't let no suck, bitch, I love how they suck dick. Once I get my nut off, bitch, I'm skating like some Chuck Fit.
Bentley, bitch. Who gives a fuck about pulling up to a fucking strip club in a 2007 Bentley, bitch? That's what he fucking told me afterwards. She don't care about driving in that shit. So then I told him, well, listen, she's in a game, I'm in a game, how about I help her? I even volunteered to go down to her raggedy ass club and help her make more money. I said the reason why Armani's not making no money is because she see Korea ass don't make money like that. You cannot put a stripper and a square together. It don't go like that. It does not go like that. You cannot put a stripper and a square together and think that shit's going to fucking work, bitch. I told him, Armani's not making no money. Not because she can't. It's because she see Korea don't make no money. So why the fuck is she about to bust her ass at the goddamn club all these every night and Korea give what she can? I told his stupid ass. He think he knows so much about the fucking game. He don't know shit. TKO don't know shit about the game. He's a fucking retard. You cannot put a square and a bitch in a game. It's never going to work. That's why their shit is up and down. That is why TKO shit is up and down. Because you cannot mix two different, totally different people in the game. You can't. So I said, listen, let me talk to Armani. He said, no, she's not going to listen to nobody. He said, listen, she didn't even talk to Gorgeous Dre's wife, and she not listening. I said, well, whoever Gorgeous Dre is, his wife ain't me. I said, I bet you she'll make money if she's talking to me and if I'm in a club with her and I'm showing, like, look, it's okay. I said, she's not making money, not because she can't. She's making money because she don't want to. She don't want to. Why the fuck would she want to be making all this money and Korea can't keep up? Why? Why, bitch? Who would? Who would? She already got to go to the club every fucking night. Korea don't work every fucking night. The bitch got a regular job. Armani got to work every night. Y'all don't remember she would go live and do her makeup at night? The bitch fucking work every fucking night. She don't go live because she be fucking tired. And he told me, if I step up to the plate, he would go leave Korea. He said, listen, if you fully step up to the plate and really fuck with me, I will leave Korea alone. TKO is all about money. He don't give a fuck who the fuck you are. If any bitch with real money say, TKO, I'm about to fuck with you, but I don't like Korea, he will leave her alone. He does not fucking like Korea ass. She be fucking on his ass. She be stressing him the fuck out. He wants to leave her alone. It's been too many times he told her, leave me alone. She won't do it. He will fucking take any bitch with some money. He is all about himself. He did not delete those messages for her. We've been talking this whole time. I'd have seen him so many times where he could have deleted it. He deleted that shit because of what he did in the fucking car when I didn't want to give him that money. I didn't want to give him that money, and he got rough with me. He got crazy in the fucking car. That's why he fucking deleted that shit. Because if I would have go to the police and say this man did this to me, it would have been no trace. It would have been no trace. It has nothing to do with fat ass Korea. He don't care. He don't care. The day you left, literally, bitch, the day you left Vegas, he fucked me. Literally, the day you probably wasn't even all the way in your house yet, bitch. The day you left, he fucked me. It don't got shit to do with you. It don't. It don't got nothing to do with you. Nothing. He could have deleted the messages a million times. A million times. He did it because his ass got physical with me in that goddamn car. And I sat there in the car like crying. And I was like, fuck. Like, I mean, I never been through a situation like that. So he didn't know if I was going to call the police or what. I didn't even drive. Like, he did that at the stoplight. I sat there after he fucking snatched the phones out of the fucking charger. We sat in the fucking car. And I didn't drive because I was in shock. Like, what the fuck? Like, this nigga really need this money bad. He's not going to tell y'all. I just hate that he's a fucking liar. It's about to make me cry. Like, bitch, stop fucking lying, bitch. That's not why you deleted the messages. You did not delete it for neither one of them. You did it because of what the fuck you did in the fucking car. Damn! I can't stand him. I just don't like a liar. I hate a fucking liar. I hate a liar.
Stupid. I don't want you leading nobody on. And you don't even fucking need that. Like, hold on. What the fuck?
Hold on, gang. Am I leading anybody on?
You are. Do you know what you promised me?
Hold on, listen.
Do you know what you promised me?
Listen, they saying no.
Yeah, because they don't know the truth. They don't know the truth. They don't know what's off you camera, trip, bro.
But how is this? The truth is
they don't know what's off camera.
You say I'm leading somebody on camera. So we talk about what's on camera.
No. But what are you talking about? In general, overall, baby. Overall. Yeah,
but you don't never let me explain anything so they can hear both sides. You just talking so. Whatever perspective, and they still not going with your perspective because they see that you don't allow me to talk. So because you don't want to look stupid.
Babe, are you gonna keep it 100 about every fucking thing?
We talking about this shit.
But are we gonna keep it 100 about everything?
Man, look.
Everything.
She doing too
everything.
Much.
Everything.
She doing
everything.
Too much.
Everything. Everything.
Man. Whatever you want to talk about live to the public, okay. Go ahead and do that. I'm not disclosing none of my.
Let's go. If that's what you want to do. Let's talk about the other.
You talk about all of it.
Everything.
If that's what you want to do, go ahead. Start yours.
Nicole, the thing is that, oof. Hold up. Let me just say this. So the thing is it happens to the best of us. That's all I want to say. That's it. It just happens to the best of us. And it's okay. It is what it is. It's okay. It's fine. You know what? I'm cool. I'm cool. Yeah, I just... Hold up real quick. Hold up.
Hold up. Yesterday, I didn't say whatever happened.
Hold up.
Yesterday, I'm talking about, man.
Front for the
line. Why are you...
Because you just now... You've been telling me every day you're about to fucking move out here and do
this
shit.
Yes, listen. Did I not say
it's
whatever?
Listen. Stop lying.
Listen. Did I not say that whatever from this day forward, we going to move on and work on everything?
So why
and then I was going to move out. Did I not say that?
So why can you do that when I was in poly?
Because you haven't. It's still issues. What you mean?
Talking about the receipts for that? You don't think she got a girl said TKO hit them? No. Because he do hit. He might be short like a leprechaun, but he do hit. You piss him off enough, he will hit you. Do y'all think he hit all them? Absolutely. Any bitch say they got hit by that man, I believe it. What that guy lied for? What that guy lied for? You see him hit. No, he hit me, bitch. That's how I know he hit. Oh, so that just sits like that? That blue thing just sit like that?
Yep.
She know he put. Yes, I already told my story 3 years ago. I wasn't lying, but he only hit me one time. And after he apologized, I forgave him. Just like what most women do. When they get hit by a man that they fuck with, and a man apologized, they usually stay. I wasn't lying. I'm still saying this 3 years later. He only hit me one time, though. And it was for something I said. Right? Y'all said true, because that's what most people do. When they're dealing with somebody who's abusive, once the person say sorry, they usually forgive them. Yeah, not me. I'm gone and he go get locked up. Yeah, but when you actually like have feelings for somebody, you don't want to go to jail. I wasn't about to go to the police. And I wasn't about to hit him back because it happened in my car. You think I'm about to fuck up a $100,000 car in the inside and I know this nigga don't got a fucking dollar to fix something? You think two motherfuckers who the same height gonna be swinging inside of my fucking expensive ass car and I know he ain't got no money to fix a fucking part that's gonna fall off? Hell no, I ain't hit that man back. If we was outside of the car, I would hit him back, but you ain't about to be knocking my mirror off and my clicker off and my goddamn whatever else is inside of a fucking car. And I gotta turn around and spend all that money. And you picked me up because you needed some money? Fuck that. I don't regret nothing I did. And y'all can't make me change my mind. I don't regret nothing I did. I gave him what I wanted to give him. I'm not like the rest of the women that's like, I'm a victim and all that. I knew what it was. I knew that man a pimp. Thank you, boo-boo. So you can't say he played me. How he played me, I knew what I was doing. I knew that man's a goddamn pimp. That man said a million times, to be with him, you got to contribute. We all knew you got to get that man money. I'm not about to ever be on here and say I'm a victim. I knew what the fuck I was doing, and I don't regret nothing that I did. I'm out the situation. I'm with K9, my husband, and you guys are not gonna make me change my mind. I'm the only woman that's gonna say I don't regret nothing I did with him. I don't regret nothing I did.
I said he makes it seem, she makes it seem, Armani makes it seem as if they have this great relationship that's perfect. But every girl that's ever been around them has always said that something is off and Armani is miserable.
Yeah, it's because it's true.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you for your honesty.
He told me himself that he trained her to act like that on camera.
I feel bad for the girl because it seems like she doesn't really have no friends, no life, no hobbies, just nothing going for herself. She's just stuck in that house. Girl, you should have took her with you. You should have kidnapped her.
No, she's not going anywhere. It's actually sad.
Oh, man. Well, thank you for your honesty, honey.
And it was not that good. We had sex twice and it was not that good. So I don't know why everyone's saying that it's good and it's not. It's average as hell. A little bit below average.
Hey honeybee, I had came in a little bit late, so I was wondering for the people who like just came in not too long in, And
we were just dancing and we were having a normal night, and then all of a sudden she just was crying. And
like, so you guys went to work together, and then you had a drink.
He was fucking pissed. Exactly. He was pissed. I saw it in his face. He had like that, you know how like ex-convicts have like that crazy like look in their eyes? They got the big eyes and they're like grinding their teeth. That's how he was looking. He was pissed. He was embarrassed because it was literally the first night that me and Armani had met. He was pissed. He is very evil behind closed doors. Don't let that fucking spiritual wrap my hair up shit fool you, bitch. Please don't let it fool you. The ex-con look, that ex-comic look when your eyes are just like all over the place. Like, yo, the ex-comic look, I cannot make this up. He threw her in the fucking car. And she had peed on herself. He threw her in the back seat. Yeah, Yetta's not lying, guys. She's not lying. I was just playing it off while I was in LA, but I knew she wasn't lying when I witnessed what I witnessed. Yetta's not lying. After I saw it for myself, she's not lying. He threw Armani in the back seat. And she was telling him to get off of her. No, dead ass free Armani. I feel so bad. I'm not gonna lie. It's not cute, though. It's not cute. You're not being someone's queen if you're being manipulated and abused mentally, physically, emotionally. It's not cute. You're not a queen at that point. You're just looking like a fucking prisoner. There's nothing cute about that. And y'all sitting here talking about Queen Armani. She is trapped in her own fucking world. It's fucking sad. It's fucking sad. I don't give a fuck about the NDA. Take me to court. I already said that. Take me to fucking court. I already spoke. Take me to court, bitch. I don't give a fuck anymore. Because what y'all not finna do is play on my fucking record, on my face. I'd rather sit here and tell y'all the honest to God's truth than sit here and play stupid behind closed doors. When I'm off Bego, I really know what's going on. But when I'm on Bego, I'm gonna sit here and fucking act like I'm gonna play stupid. I'm not doing that shit no more. Thank you, Bumblebee. I'm not playing stupid no more to protect this nigga. That's what everyone does. They play stupid to protect TKO. For what? What are you really protecting? A 5'5" nigga with a 7-inch dick? That's not even that good? Let's keep it fucking real. The dick ain't even that good. So what is y'all all obsessing over? But I'm a stalker. Ain't, that dick is not worth stalking, baby. Fuck. That's why I don't know why Array was tripping so hard last night. Bitch, it ain't even all that. You ain't missing out on shit.
Hey, honey, it's me. I'm back again, baby. I forgot to ask. Did he say anything to you about you providing him with money?
Yeah,
join this angel.
Hey, he said they're finna get a new house like in Atlanta, and he wants 10K, and he wants to move to Atlanta because that's the city where they do that shit at.
So he ran the same game on you as he did Yetta.
It's obvious that's why he wants to move to Atlanta. He wants to be closer to where all the trannies is at and shit. No shade. I'm just saying.
I can believe that. I can believe that. That's what I wanted to know, if he ran the same game as he did on Yetta.
I wanted to give him the money. Do I look stupid to y'all? Fuck.
Hell no, you better not be. You better go on and make your money, live your life, take care of your kids, find you a good man, and be happy. Shit, you deserve to be the one and only.
Period.
All right, baby, I'm going down.
Bye.
The second night that I lived there, I moved in on March 18th. It's a Thursday. Saturday night, we got drunk, me and Armani, on his live. Me and her was pretty, like, vibing. We was kind of all up on each other. We had a good time. And then after his live ended, I guess he felt some type of way. And he told Armani she was acting funny. I don't really know exactly how it all, like, went left. But this nigga straight slapped her, backhanded her in front of me in the living room. And I lost it. I was bawling. I was all tears. She started packing all her shit. She popped off all her press-on nails. She went and packed up all her stuff. I'm like screaming and shit. He left the house immediately. The police came because she called her parents and said that she was coming home. And she started throwing all her shit into a bag. And I'm begging her not to leave. She said that he would never do that to me. He would only just do it to her, and that I would be straight, and that I'd be better for him, and that all of this other bullshit or whatever. So I'm like, if you leave, I'm gonna leave. I ain't no way in hell I could put up with this type of shit. Hell nah. So she left. He came back home. Armani had took an Uber. She went to the fucking airport. Yeah. She left. I cried myself to sleep on the couch with him. Woke up the next day, texted Armani, like, are you okay? Where are you? She upstairs. This bitch is upstairs. So I was like, oh, I'm glad you didn't leave. Good. Okay, cool. Can you come with me to LA today? Because I was going back to get the rest of my stuff. Yes, this is my first time telling this story, y'all. I was like, I already bought a bus ticket. Because he told me when we first left LA and I had left majority of all my stuff, he told me that he wasn't coming back from none of this crap. He was like, you already have too much stuff. Y'all, mind you, I moved from LA to Vegas with an SUV's worth of stuff. An SUV, that's it. Just my clothes could have filled up all of that, to be honest. He wouldn't take me back, so I bought a bus ticket that morning before I even knew Armani was there. Bought a bus ticket, reserved a pickup truck at the airport, and I was gonna go by myself and get somebody in LA to help me since he wasn't gonna help me. So when she didn't leave, I was like, okay, cool. I'm glad you're still here. You're okay, cool. You want to come to LA? She was like, I'm not coming with you because I want to take as much time as I can with the dogs because I'm leaving on Monday. So, no, it was Friday night because it was my second night there. Yeah, so Thursday night and Friday night, he smacked her in front of me. And then Saturday morning was when we were supposed to go to LA. And she didn't want to go because she wanted to take up as much time as she could with the dogs before she left because she was still going to leave on Monday. I went downstairs and told TKO, Armani said she's still leaving, and he got so fucking pissed. He ran upstairs and started telling her, if you want to go, then go. If you want to leave, leave now then, bitch. He's all in her fucking face, and then she starts crying, and she's saying she don't really want to go.
Girl, sis, am I interrupting anything? Because I know you've been in some shit. I was just now
with me because she needed to spend as much time as she could with her dogs before she had to go, and then she was still planning on leaving on Monday. Why did I beg her to stay? Because, like, I didn't want to stay there with his ass without her. Everybody say, oh, Yetta wanted to take your spot, bitch. No the fuck I didn't. I don't want to be nothing like her, y'all. Like, she thinks I want to have her position, bitch. No way. You have to clean up after him and put up with his attitude and then him blaming it all on you. He always says Armani's got bad energy, Armani's bad vibes, Armani bringing down the energy in the house, Armani this, Armani that. No, it's you, it's him. And me and her had multiple conversations about it. We just look at each other like, he's awful. He ran upstairs, told Armani, if you want to go, then go. If you still finna leave on Monday, why wait? Just leave now. Leave now. I got you on a ticket. I'll buy your fucking plane ticket. She was like, there are no flights. I'm getting out on Monday. And then eventually, like 5 minutes into the argument, she's crying and saying she don't really want to go. That's not really what she want to do. That was the day, the morning she woke up with the fucking cold sore, y'all. That morning. That shit sprouted up overnight. Yeah. And then she begged to stay, said that she didn't really want to leave. And then he's like, and you don't even want to support your sister? You ain't even trying to support your sister and take her? You ain't trying to help her with her stuff in LA? And that would be a perfect moment for y'all to bond? And you ain't even trying to support your sister when she needs you? He tried to spin it all on her like she was being selfish for wanting to leave after he smacked her in front, fucking front of me, yo. Yeah. Thank you, Pepsi, baby. I know these halls way too well. And she knew everywhere to park. She's like, oh, I definitely know where we are. Like, saying stuff like that. She done been all up and down them goddamn hotel halls. Did he fuck you more than he fuck Armani? I don't know, because he was always trying to be secret whenever we fucked. He said, shh, Armani might hear. Gotta be quiet, leave me quiet. And I think he liked to do that because it took him back to the jail days when he used to have to sneak and fuck niggas in the ass. Because I'm like, why we gotta be quiet? She know we fucking. We live
together. That's dumb as fuck.
I seriously think that's what gave him his dick hard, trying to be sneaky. And, you know, Armani would say, I was like, oh, y'all was probably finna fuck her. So she was she said, she gonna say, no, that's what you're here for. I said, what? You don't like sex? And she was like, it's not that I don't like sex. It's just that I get sick of doing the same thing all the time. I was like, in the butt. And she's like, yeah. She gets sick of always getting fucked in the ass. I would get sick of that shit too. Shit, I used to get fucked in a pussy though. The one he say stank. Of course, that's what I always, niggas want to say the girlfriend pussy stank when they get out of the relationship. Yeah, of course, right, yeah, the pussy stank. I bet you I could find the YouTube where you said my pussy had no smell, TKO. And thought she wasn't even really black. He's talking about me. He's saying that I thought I wasn't really black. No, nigga, I'm always trying to convince everyone. Yes, I'm a fucking black girl. Yes, I'm a black girl. No, I don't have a white mom or a white dad. I don't even have a white grandma or a white grandpa. My people is black. And he would always call me white girl this, white girl that. And I was like, I let him know during the relationship, I don't like that you're always calling me white. Stop. So he's trying to tell everybody now that I don't think I'm a real black girl. Like, he really trying to drag me, y'all. He really trying to turn people against me. He's really trying to make y'all think I'm some type of black hater. No, that's your bitch. She don't even want to get a tan. And if you want a fork, you got to open the dishwasher and find one there. They only have about four. I don't know.
I'm a bougie bitch. I don't even stick my hands in there with a what's it called? A sponge to clean my own shit. I have to have one.
I don't want to reach inside the toilet bowl,
come on,
period.
Man, that's nasty.
They don't got no toilet brush. The whole backyard is littered with dog shit. So why he trying to talk about, he said, I washed out my cat litter in the sink. That's not true. I washed my cat's bowls out in the sink. Yes, where he eats, he gets water and he has food. I washed his dishes and he thought that was gross.
Wait, so a lot of people say his house is not furnished because they always sit in one spot. Is that true?
Yes. He has a couch. They have a couch when you first walk in, that toe-up ass couch that y'all all know and love. And then he has one of those dorm-style floor lamps with like six arms that bend in different ways. You know how kids get when they first 18 and they go away to the dorm? That's what they get, that lamp. That's what he got. And they have no dining room table. The only chairs they have in the house are that gaming chair that I bought and the three plastic bar stools. There's one plastic bar stool that's broken, so that one doesn't count. When we used to sit on them uncomfortable ass plastic bar stools for Drip Idol, our asses would be falling asleep the whole fucking time. Uncomfortable as hell. When we had to change the air filter for the air conditioning that went out like three times while we were living there, I had to hold steady the gaming chair. Had to hold the gaming chair steady under the filter so TK could get up there and try to put it on, because there's not a stable surface to stand on, period. They have two nightstands in their room next to their king-size bed that is also broken. They don't sleep on the bed. There ain't no TV upstairs. That's why they say they don't sleep on the bed, because they want to fall asleep watching TV. So they sleep on the couch head-to-head down there at the bottom. And don't brush their teeth before they go to sleep. I had to bring that up. Hey, you guys should probably floss. You don't floss.
They don't floss.
And also brush your teeth before bed.
Gingivitis is serious.
And they didn't brush their teeth before bed until I told them they should.
Gingivitis is real, bitches. Y'all gotta take care of y'all gums and in between y'all teeth.
So they wanna talk about my apartment and I'm a hoarder. Nigga, shut the fuck up. You came the day before I moved. It was shit everywhere, I'm not gonna lie. And I left most of it there because I wasn't allowed to bring it. He came to pick me up in an SUV. That's all I could do was pack the SUV with all of my stuff. You think all of my stuff would fit in a fucking SUV? I needed a 10-foot truck. She used to ask me to sneak and bring her back a Four Locos.
She still drink Four Locos? That's childish. That's some high school.
One time she
before I went to the liquor store, she asked me to bring an empty water bottle with me and fill it up with Four Locos and then stick it in my fanny pack and sneak it back into the house. And I was like, no, what if he catches me? Wait, is she going to blame it all on me and say that she didn't ask me to do that?
David, that's weird. You got to do all that as a grown woman. You got to go behind his, like, this bitch is so crazy.
Yep. I think she had to sneak it because she says she had to sneak it because when she drinks alcohol, she gets crazy. And she kind of blamed it on herself that day that he slapped her in front of me because she was drunk and she got mouthy.
That's why her pee was so yellow. My thing is, if you're going to show your pee on live, bitch, and you know it's a storyline, at least drink water 24 hours before. Bitch, like,
I know, right? Why would you put that on live anyway? Like, you're definitely clout chasing, bruh. Like, it's stupid as hell to leave it on live when you're gonna pregnancy test anyway. Like, my sister's like 4 months pregnant. She just now announced it on Facebook and stuff. Because you never know if you're gonna lose the baby or not. Why would you want to put all of that shit out for the public to see you going through that? And then
a woman.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
I ain't got nothing left to say. That's weird.
I just want y'all to ask him a few questions. If y'all get over there on your foo-foo or whatever, because you know you're going to get kicked out. Ask him to show you a toilet brush in the house. They don't got no toilet brushes. Ask him to show you the backyard so that you can see all of the dog shit that they don't pick up. Ask him to give you a house tour so you can see how they ain't got no furniture and it look like a trap house. And then ask them what did Yetta ever do to you? I've taken the trash out a couple times, but Armani always wheels it down every Tuesday to the curb and bring that motherfucker back.
Just finished the
word. Ask him where the toilet brush at. Ask him to show you the busted bathroom door on the first floor.
Oh.
Ask him how the door got busted. It says a lot about you standing there in that filth. Shut the fuck up. I didn't stay in the backyard with the dog shit, bitch. Hey, Tan.
What, they expect you to clean up the dog shit as a woman?
I don't fucking know. Tan, thank you. Right. The bathroom door downstairs that he says the dog's locked behind them. Y'all, the whole bathroom door looks like it's been kicked in. There's a big hole in the door, all right? A huge door, hole in the door. And I asked, what happened to the bathroom door? And Armani was like, you gonna have to ask him. And so then I asked him, and he wouldn't tell me. And then I asked again later, weeks later. Thank you for the bells, Ferragamo. I asked him again, Jersey Moss hated, thank you. And he gonna say, well, the dogs locked themselves in there one day and I had to break the door down to let them out. You know, he was talking about Armani when he said the dogs. Armani's the one who locked herself in there. Thank you! Probably trying to protect herself from him beating the fuck out of her. And then he broke the door down and did it anyway.
Okay.
But still, he is not a man to me. He just want to be motherfucking catered to.
He don't take the trash out.
Being dropped in his
he
mouth.
Don't clean the house. He don't do the all dishes. He don't take the trash out. Armani wheels the trash down to the curb. Back. He don't do shit.
What?
I'm serious. Yes.
I'm not doing it. Wait, let me get this straight. You can't hear. question. I really want to know about, I have so many questions about certain people's poly relationships. If you got three adults in the house who are making money, like the way y'all make money on this app, why wouldn't y'all just hire a maid? It sounds like y'all all make enough money collectively to have somebody else come clean.
Well, you know, before when he rescued
me. Because you lose responsibility. You lose responsibility. No
when
shame.
He rescued me you from do. My shack, you guys, because it says I lived in a shack, which was a studio apartment in L.A. I had a housekeeper. She came every Thursday.
I have a housekeeper now. I mean, like,
yeah.
I would just get a housekeeper. Like, why? I'm not doing chores.
Well, no, the thing is, Armani says she likes.
But then again, you lose responsibility, no shame.
What happened between you and TKO? And I said I was going to leave it alone. But I cannot leave this alone. I'm sorry in advance. I cannot leave it alone. me and him had a genuine connection. Me and him was building on a friendship at first. Friends, just that, that's it. I let it be known I'm not on that wave. He understood it. Point blank, period. But we kept seeing synchronicities with each other. Like when I'm seeing 111 right now, talking about him, 222, 333, all that other stuff. But come to figure out, to me, you know, later down the line, I know that it doesn't mean shit. It don't mean nothing. But back then, when I was ignorant and naive, I thought it was, because I'm praying, I'm meditating, I'm manifesting, and he appears. So I'm thinking, oh, this is an opportunity. But that's something I had to learn. You know, sometimes, you know, just understand that things aren't always a fucking opportunity, Nafira. What happened between me, TKO? We had a regular fallout, just like everyone else. It just went public. And people have the audacity to have their opinions about what's going on when they ain't no shit. People are going through real life hurt. People are going through real life trauma. People are going through real life, whatever. Drama. So, what happened was, like I told him, we texted, you know, I was not about to give up who I'm becoming to go backwards and be someone that looks like she has a lot of freedom and fun, but at the back of my mind, I'm like, I can't unlearn what I already learned about myself. I can't unlearn that I am of this, and this is my culture and my religion. I couldn't give that up. And I want to be myself, yes, but I can be myself through what I'm doing. I want to be myself. I want to stay true to who I am. But I didn't want to lose the doctrine. I didn't want to lose the healing that I was doing. I didn't want to lose the information. I didn't want to lose who I am becoming. And I felt like it was a choice that I had to make. And again, about the war thing that I messaged him about, because a lot of people saw what happened and I messaged him confused. I'm like telling him, like, I feel like I gotta choose. And in that moment, I'm really coming to him sad and wanting something, some kind of reassurance. There was none. It was just, all right, well, since you're confused. And I'm just like, really, nigga? Like, after all that you've been saying, you think that we could do something, we can build, we can do music, you think I'm a good fit? I thought I was a good fit. You know, all this other stuff. It's so easy for you to, all right. Oh, I never had a girl that can sing. So it's so easy for people to. So I was just like, yeah, my mentor was right about you. You know, sweet talking me. And then all of a sudden I'm coming up to you like really confused on some like, yo, talk to me type shit. Crying on the phone with him saying they're saying you're about to pimp me. And all you can tell me is, I know. You're not reassuring me that you're not about to pimp me. So that's what happened. If you guys take it or leave it, that's what happened. After that, I was just like, I'm gonna leave it alone. Yeah, I started telling him to take down the video because it shouldn't be up. I thought he was a person of love. I didn't know he was gonna come back with a two wrongs don't with mix a right thing. I thought he was gonna be like, y'all, like, he, that's what made me like really want to build with that person, because I thought he was all about, you know, he's not about the clout, he's not about all that judgment. He want to build with people. So when I saw that, I'm just like, nah, it's not about taking people, women and stuff like that. It's about the love of it, the love of life, and finding people that you can experience that with. I love music. I always wanted to do music. when we connected and vibed through music and other things too. But that's the thing, like, nah, like, you gotta see things for what it is. And that's why I was, like, all upon what I was taught. You know, I wanted to, yeah, like, I listened to my mentor. I listened to him, and I seen what, and I did my own research, and I seen way past what someone's trying to show me, you know? So, yeah, that's what happened. Keeping it a buck. Ain't no money involved. Nothing. It was genuine connection. And people want to say, oh, she used you. She manipulated the situation. She da-da-da-da-da-da. You don't know shit. Excuse my language. Excuse my French. I'm really not trying to come out of Nafira. But this has to be addressed. And I refused. I refuse to allow my name to get tarnished any longer. Y'all stepping up to a motherfucking goddess. Y'all better know that shit. Believe that. Believe that. I'm gonna get my stuff together. And y'all not gonna keep bringing me down when I'm trying to get my bring myself back up. That's not what y'all not gonna do. That's not what y'all not gonna do. What you are gonna do is respect this. Respect me. Because I'm respecting myself. I'm making decisions for myself. And people might not agree with my decisions. But I'm being cautious with myself. And I have to be. I'm a goddess. I can build some people up. Like I said, and that's the thing. Y'all want to... The media is so messy. They don't get the first half of what my video was with, you know, wherever I was doing. They don't want to get the first half. They cut right in the middle of it. When, oh, wait, TKO saying, oh, you didn't defend me. You didn't lift a finger for me. Da 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 da. You don't know that. I was defending your name to my teacher. Someone I trust with my life. Defending your name. Defending you. That's why people say, oh, she talked about you so beautifully. You don't know that. But you don't know that because they want to show you the mess. They don't want to show you what I was truly saying about you. So was I hurt? Eh. Am I hurt now? I'm just tired. I'm pissed. I'm off about people slandering me. And I got my guard up. And it's all the way up. And I got soldiers around me. And I got a power within me. I did chants yesterday. I'm feeling strong. I feel vocal. I want to let it be known. Nafira ain't nothing to be messed with, yo. Y'all better stop messing with me. Because it's nothing. And I promise you that. You ever think that maybe you were brought into their lives to teach and uplift them? That's a fact. I know that I am. And they can teach and uplift me. Ain't no one street. Ain't no one street. That's a fact. Y'all not about to do that. And y'all not about to do that to me. So at the end of the day, let Nafira say it to you first. That all the clout and all the chasing and all the negative narratives can just go. I don't even want to say that. Could be just gone. Because this right here is love. And this right here is going to get somewhere. This right here, is the truth. I'm acknowledging my truth. I got my own mind. I know what I'm doing. And sometimes I don't know what I'm doing. But it's up for me to understand that. It's up to me. It's okay, you have to open up. I know. What do you think about the conversation they had with that lady on YouTube talking about you? And that's one of the things, the reasons why I came on live, because it's like, they don't know me. Even TKO has said he known me. He don't really know me like that. He saw my energy. We was there. I went to Vegas for a day. They don't know me. And they're judging me. And you know what? Can we blame them? Can we blame them? They don't know me. My mentor knows me. I know me. Thank you for being you. You're a beautiful person. Thank you. I appreciate that. You seem more focused on the wordplay of this world rather than the goddess inside of you. I don't know what you're talking about. On the play of this world? You're saying the fun in the games, the clout, the social media. Are you saying that? Because that's not true. That's not true in the slightest. I focus on my growth. And this for me right here is growth. And you don't even know it. On so many levels. On so many levels. If I would have responded then, I would have when they was doing that panel on me and all this other stuff, I would have responded in emotion and rage. I'm glad that I'm responding the way I'm responding now. Calm, grounded, that like I am. The person I am. Respectfully. And I shouldn't have ever even responded. I didn't have to respond. I didn't have to. But here's the thing. I'm making decisions. I'm seeing how my decisions weigh up. And it took me a while. It took me a good while to respond. Because I didn't want the hate, the clout. I was just like, I'm just didn't want any of that. Having self-control and self-discipline, that's a fact. And even now, I should be having self-control and self-discipline even more. But that's it, y'all. That's all I wanted to say. Stop with the bashing. Stop with the manipulation of situations. And just focus on you. Focus on your life. People have drama out here, and y'all always think it's for clout. Y'all always think it's for a game. Y'all always think it's about manipulation. Y'all always wanting to come into somebody's life and tell them what to do. What about your own? Y'all think it's a TV show. Y'all think it's a game. People out here are having real emotions, real feelings, real life situations. And that's why I'm just like, that's why I came on and I'm speaking to the young women too. Because I am young. I've been through certain things. And yes, you do have to be careful out here. I've been through many situations that I've been manipulated and abused and everything. I'm not saying that that's what happened over there. I'm just saying right now, I guess I can be an advocate for that. So let me be that. What's wrong with that? There's nothing wrong with that. And I stand proudly, and I would do my best to speak up for the little girls. Because I actually care about my people. People are saying they care about their people, but you know when you really care about your people. But anyway, y'all, that is it. I respect it, and I respect it too. And from now on, when the fear has something to say, the fear is going to say.
Went out there knowing that, like you said, there was a school out there that you wanted to attend.
Yeah. So, like, that's why I think, like, he started hitting me. Because I think he kind of realized that I'm not really this idiot. Like, I have a voice. Like, I'm not this type of person that is slow. Like, so I think he was upset. Like, he started acting out. And I was just like, this nigga's a loser. Like, I was just like, So it just was a bittersweet thing. I stopped feeling bad for both of them. I stopped feeling bad for either one of them. Because I felt like she knows what's going on. And I also felt like he kept playing a role.
So did you ever register for school out there, Boss Life?
No, I never registered for school there. I was still going to school. I still was going to school. I ended up dropping my online class in September.
Mm-hmm.
So I never fully registered for class. I never registered.
Mm-mm. When you told TKO that your plan was to go to school out there, did he ever try to, like, turn your mind around away from your education?
Where TKO lost was when he tried to say that he put me in that position. I already put my life in position. Mm-hmm. I already put my own self through school. I never said that me being a dancer was incorrect. I never done anything illegal. I've never done anything to degrade myself. So I never felt like TKO never took me away from anything that wasn't something I already did. I went there with my own school. I went there with my own life. Like, I wasn't ever in a position of not being respected. Like, I was always on top.
Where would you say that the disrespect with him set in at? Like, when was the first time that he just brutally went off and disrespected you to the utmost? And maybe in that moment, you felt like, I'm not going to deal with this. Like, this is another side of you that I'm seeing that I didn't expect.
I just witnessed everything. I saw when he would, like, go, he was just a bothersome person. Like, I saw when he would go, like, in the kitchen to physically be in the kitchen because he knew I liked to cook my food.
Mm-hmm.
When I was enjoying myself and he would put the camera on me.
And I'm sorry, put your CA up there. They asked for your CA.
But so, at a point in time. When did it come to the point where he made you feel like, you know, you had to go on a diet and then you couldn't eat? Like, I remember when you said you would go in the kitchen and he would always come in there and he would, like, try to discourage you from cooking a meal and maybe ask you to get a piece of fruit or. What was that with him?
So, so I had always gone, I had a personal gym. A private gym where I had lived. So I always went to the gym. I already had the plan of getting into my own mode. I already did that. He never made me go to a gym. Like, I already had did that. So it was just cool to go to the gym, you know, because that's what I like to do. But to be tried to be degraded because of who I am, it never pushed me. Oh my God. It never pushed me in a better direction.
Boss Life, like, I hate to tell you, boo, this is totally too much. She don't, you know, you're asking, I'm understanding you, but it's totally too much. And I know Boss Life ain't going to really say nothing, you know, so it Boss should Life, be an end to it. Boss yeah. Life should be an end to it. Into it, all, it Boss it, Life.
Bless girl, it all is a lot. But you have to understand that I'm high class.
But I'm saying with the, you know, asking the questions.
Okay, so Bless Girl, I understand that you and her both have a mutual friendship from Bigo, right? And then you're her admin and you have her phone number. Did you ever just sit down and talk to her? Do y'all know that outside of this being Bigo, this is personal life? Like, this is a woman that's young, thriving, that have been robbed of her innocence in so many ways than others, you know, that basically is sitting here now lusting over the fact that she gave money that she thought was a close friend, right? So it, beyond money, this is her life. You get what I'm saying? This is a woman's life. This is something that she's dealing with outside of Bigo. She obviously is home, right? And she comes on Bigo to vent. And it's like everybody bashes her more than just checking in on her, checking her mental, asking about things that are important. Y'all call yourself doing interviews and pay. When at the end of the day, her receiving money or beans is not going to change the fact that she went through real life trauma, real life abuse.
Excuse me, I talked
to Vegas with a career, a driver's license, and everything that she bought, built up on her own before TKO. She left Vegas with a DUI, a suspended driver's license, got to go through this, got to go through that, was arrested after being abused, leaving because she was trying to get away from something, which is what y'all are missing. Y'all see TKO as this person, because before you knew Boss Life, Bless Girl, I am certain that you were a woman that supported TKO. So understand that.
No, ma'am.
As a person on this app, I never met not a soul, not a human being off this app. You get what I'm saying? Not ever. But I sit back as other viewers do with my right mind and a strong conscience to know that a lot of things that have went on is not about beans. Mm-hmm. It's not about money. It's about getting justice and letting somebody speak to her so that the story that y'all keep on halfway asking is getting out.
Yeah.
That's enough. Mm-hmm. But she has her own mom over there. And it takes somebody like me who's not a host on Bego. I'm getting in the box and I'm having a conversation with a young girl that I am concerned about mentally, because I also am a woman that has been through sexual abuse, domestic abuse. I was in an abusive relationship for 2 years of my life. So when y'all think that it's okay to just get up and get out, it's not that easy. But once you out, guess what? It's more of a testimony than it is about a check. Are y'all crazy?
So after all this Bego trauma, you went on and continued your life to try to be bigger and better.
Yes, actually, because I was so fearful. I don't want to say fearful, but I didn't go with what the plan was. Sorry, my phone. Since I didn't want to go with the plan of what he wanted me to do, I was fearful of getting out because I was being used for my benefits. So I actually, instead of getting out like my plan was, I decided to stay in for another 3 years, and I'm moving to another duty station in like a couple of weeks. So I'm sorry.
So that's okay. You're okay. Are you nervous? Okay. Calm. Okay. Give her a moment.
Oh, God.
This is what they leave behind, y'all. These men beat us. They take us for everything we have, and what they leave behind is women that are so emotional and traumatized. This girl running for her life. Guess where she went to hide it? In the United States government. That's where she went to hide. I don't want to come back on normal ground. I need to go hide. I'm going to go hide for 3 more years. This is what they leave, because she didn't want to go with the plan. She didn't want to go with his plan. They don't know the path they lay. They don't know the destruction they leave behind for some of us. Some of us are able to cope and move on, but some of us become women that can't focus in society on a normal, just normal socializing. It's awkward for some of us. Some of us are socially awkward. We can't even relate to normal situations. Some of us become defensive against men. Some of us only want to turn to women. You just never know. Some of us turn to counseling. Some of us cut our wrists. Some of us go to suicide.
And y'all don't realize I've dealt with this man when he first got on the app. So a lot of people that keep on saying, oh, you know what, y'all know what y'all signed up for. I didn't. He was brand new to this app. The first poly auditions, I was the first one to be in it. And when I was in Korea, this man would literally, like, but even before I got to Korea, I went to go see him, even with Cash Boo. Her and I went to go see him together. That was years ago.
Valley, what was the plan? What was the plan? What was his plan that you weren't with?
So the plan, there was a few things that he wanted me to follow. So he wanted me to leave the military and go up with him. And he wanted to use my benefits on what I could provide for him. He wanted me to give him my disability checks from the VA. He wanted to do a lot. he wanted to, everything that I pretty much was able to make money off of as far as my injuries, he wanted to take that. And he wanted to have a baby with me so that baby can get those benefits as well. So he would be able to access those benefits a lot easier than just, you know, me to just, you know, other than him saying, just hand it over.
And who are we talking about? Who is this man?
TKO.
This is a young woman that's been injured. The government is paying her for her survival, for her service. And he wants to take it and leave her blind and crippled with nothing. Give me that. Go ahead, Valerie.
When I got there, it was pretty much like it was a lot of red flags. And when I initially left for Korea,
when you say Korea, she mean like South Korea, North Korea?
South Korea. And he said while I was there, he wanted me to give him like $3,000 to $4,000. And I wasn't even living in the States at the time. And that was pretty much where it started. It was just a lot of stuff where even like for his birthday, he would talk to me and he would tell me, okay, I want you to throw this dragon. I want you to throw this. I want you to throw that. I need you to throw this at this time. Like, he's very calculating on everything that he does. Like, y'all don't realize if you don't give it to him, it's your this bitch, this hoe, this, that is everything. Like, he will literally like emotionally abuse you to like until he gets fucking tired.
So you're telling me if you didn't give him your money, so not only does he want your VA benefits, he also wants your Beagle money as well.
Exactly.
And if you don't give it to him, you a bitch, you a hoe, you a slut. And he's texting and texting. I listen to this, y'all. This is the same story Boss Life and everybody else tell. He will text you from sun up to sundown and call you and manipulate you and make you feel like you're smaller than small. Then he'll take another woman and put in your face. This man know, this is his MO. He knows how to make you give in to him.
Stop mingling with people. I like to be in the background. I don't like to talk. I told my story a couple of years ago and I just disappeared. I'm not the one to keep on repeating myself over and over again. And I just wanted to leave it alone. I just wanted to not deal with it. I don't want to deal with it anymore.
Sorry, babe. Well, I won't question you in the form of an interview. Whatever you would like to share with us, we'll take it. I will not be asking you any questions because you're right. You have told your story, but I definitely wanted this new generation of Beagle to meet you. I wanted you to introduce yourself and let them know that there's more victims out there that came a long time ago. And a lot of these girls run away. Again, no 911 calls. No, they're too afraid. This girl wouldn't have hid in the system. He wanted her disability checks. She got injured. He wants that. Every dragon she made on Beagle, he wants her to empty out of his wallet. Give me your money. Do you mind telling us about the one time you did visit him, though?
So I did visit him. And mind you guys, I was stupid at first. I have a child. And it was Cashby. Was it New Year's? I think it was New Year's that you and I went over there. And I told him that, you know, at first I told him that I want to be able to, you know, spend time with my family and before I leave. And he talked me into going to go see him. So I decided to go, and which was stupid as hell. But I went there about a day or two before Cash Poo showed up. And this fool pulls up and fucking picks me up in a fucking Malibu. There's no Bentley at the time. There's no nothing at the time. Picks me up. And I knew he was lying because he lying about his age because he asked me at first, how old do you think I am? And I told him some bogus ass, you know, 20, 25, like 30 or something like that. So I know he was lying about his age at first. And that's when he said that, yeah, I'll stick with that. And pulled up to his house. And first thing I noticed was that there's big hole in the door. There was like a bathroom, like right next to his garage. And there was a big ass hole in the door. And that was the first thing I questioned, like, how the fuck did this big ass hole get in this door? Like someone damn near like got into a fight or something. And, you know, I walked in there, his couch was cut up. How the fuck did that happen? So it was a lot of things just walking in there. Emp, it was just like someone got their ass beat in here. There were so many holes, everything. There was stuff that was ripped up, broken and everything like that. And he was trying to be, you know, a gracious guest. He was trying to put on a facade, trying to put on a front. And when Cash Boo called, and I was there for that phone call, but she said that she was going to be coming. And he said that he was going to help her with the flight. And as soon as he got off the phone with her, started calling her all types of bitches. And then this bitch is going to be fucking doing too much. And like, oh, they're already calling her a bitch as soon as she got off the phone. And I know, Cash, but you don't even know about that. But she pretty much, he offered to help. But then now he's mad because he had to put down some money to help her get a flight, which I already knew that was a red flag. And it was a lot of things, Emp. I didn't like the fact that when we went to Olive Garden, we had these full-ass meals and Armani was eating fruit, just a little bowl of fruit. And I don't know if you remember that, Cashmere. She was eating fruit. She didn't want to eat. And it was just a lot of things where she was just kind of shy, kind of kept to herself. And, you know, she didn't want to be seen. She did not want to be like out in the forefront. And then I don't know, Cash, but you might have to like remember, like help me remember. But there was a time where Armani asked to get something to eat and asked for the debit card, and TKO got mad, saying, "Well, why the fuck would you have to ask? Why the fuck would you have to ask? Why the fuck, like going off on her in front of us, in front of both me and Cash Boo? Why the fuck would you have to ask? Like, no, that's not what the fuck we do, right?" Yeah, because she asked to get the card to go get something, the debit card to go get something to eat. Whoa. So it was like little stuff, even like with me and Cash Boo, I was just like, whoa, like this is a little off to me. Yeah, so it was just little stuff like that I can really like remember. But it was just the physical, the not really like anything physical that I really saw. The only thing is they had an argument upstairs, and TKO closed the door, and when he left, he kind of cracked it open a little bit and went down to go see what was going on. And as I was going downstairs, Armani was sitting in the fetal position crying with her head in her arms.
Really?
So I don't know if she got hit or anything like that, but there were like a couple of times where she would be left in the fetal position when he walked out crying, like sitting on the floor.
Jesus.
I was sitting, that nigga would whoop my ass and I would can right up like, I love you, babe.
Wow. Yeah. I am so glad you got away. Jesus.
Yeah.
Ooh. So Jesus, he is working tonight. They said the police are back at TKO's house. When I mean to tell you, Jesus, God is there. Working overtime tonight. Make sure I'm buying that baby good, honey. Okay.
Because he gonna have a rude awakening. Trust me, if I can get to Vegas soon, y'all, he gonna have a rude awakening. For thank you, Cam Bam.
Of course, I got you, girl. I'm gonna get down.
Hold on, y'all, turn them all right here. Y'all be trolling, boy. Nah, ain't nobody arguing here. Just all family. Yeah, we all family here. Yeah, I'm just a big social media. Yeah, we got 4.5 thousand people in here.
Right. And how
this is what they do, though. This is what y'all do. Can y'all give us the name of the people who's trolling us and who's calling offline?
We can't do that.
I can't give us no information, but y'all can pop up in my crib, and y'all can't give us information on who's doing this. So because that's disturbing our night now. That's not cool. They should be able to get thrown in jail or something just for like doing this.
That shit weird.
Yeah, I'm about to go back up in here.
If I was you, I would practice picking up and dropping the soap.
I see dead people.
Nothing on that beat, nope. Hey, mustard on the beat, ho. Debo, any rap nigga, he a freak throw. Man down, call like Amber Lambs, tell him breathe, bro. Nail a nigga to the cross, he walk around like Tizo. What's up with these jabroni ass niggas trying to see Compton? The industry can hate me, fuck them all and they mama. How many ops you really got? I mean, it's too many options. I'm finna pass on this body, I'm John Stockton. Beat your ass and hide the Bible if God watching. Sometimes you gotta pop out and show niggas. Certified boogeyman, I'm the one that up to score with him. Walk him down whole time, I know he got some hoe on him. Pole on him, extort shit, bully the flow on him. Say Drake, I hear you like I'm young. You better not ever go to cell block one. To any bitch that talk to him and they in love, just make sure you hide your little sister from him. They tell me Chubb's the only one that get your hand-me-downs. And party at the party playing with his nose now. And Baka got a weird case, why is he around? Certified lover boys, certified pedophiles. Wop, 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 wop. Dot, fuck him up. Wop, 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 wop. I'ma do my stuff. Why you trolling like a bitch? Ain't you tired? Trying to strike a chord, and it's probably A minor. They not like us. They not like us. They not like us. They not like us, they not like us, they not like us. You think the Bay gon' let you disrespect Pop, nigga? I think that Oakland show gon' be your last stop, nigga. They cold foul, I don't know why you still pretending. What is the owl? Bird niggas and bird bitches, go. The audience not dumb, shape the stories how you want. Hey Drake, they're not slow. Rabbit hole is still deep, I can go further, I promise. Ain't there something? P-Rest, that's for bitchin'. You Malibu most wanted, ain't no law boy, you ball boy. Fetch Gatorade or something. Since 2009, I had this bitch jumpin'. You niggas will get a wedgie, be flipped over your boxes. Or over your foe, the other vaginal option. Pussy, nigga better straighten they posture. Got famous all up in content, might write this with a doctor. Tell a pop star quit hiding, fuck a caption, won't action. No accident, I'm hands on, he fuck around, get polished. Fucked on Wayne girl while he was in jail, that's conniving. Then get his face tatted like a bitch apologizing. I'm glad D Rose came home, y'all didn't deserve him neither. From Alondra down to Central, nigga better not speak on Serena. And your homeboy needs subpoena, that predator moving flocks. That name gotta be registered and placed on neighborhood watch. I lean on you niggas like another line of walk. Yeah, it's all eyes on me and I'ma send it up the pot. Ay, put the wrong label on me, I'ma get them drop, ay, sweet chin music and I won't pass the ox, ay, how many stocks do I really have in stock, ay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plus 5, ay, devil is a lie, he a 69 god, ay, freaky ass niggas need to stay their ass inside, ay, roll their ass up like a fresh pack of Zon, ay, city is back up, it's a must, we outside, ay. They not like us, they not like us, they not like us. They not like us, they not like us, they not like us. Once upon a time, all of us was in chains. Homies still doubled down, calling us some slaves. Atlanta was the mecca, building railroads and trains. Bear with me for a second, let me put y'all on game. The settlers was using town folk to make them richer. Fast forward 2024, you got the same agenda. You run to Atlanta when you need a check balance. Let me break it down for you, this the real nigga challenge. You caught Future when you didn't see the club. Hey, what? Lil Baby help you get your lingo up. What? 21, get your first street cred. Thug made you feel like you a slime in your head. Hey, what? Quavo said you can be from Northside. But 2 Chainz say you good, but he lied. You run to Atlanta when you need a few dollars. No, you not a colleague, you a fucking colonizer. The family matter and the truth of the matter. Here was God's plan to show y'all the liar. He a fan, he a fan, he a fan. He a fan, he a fan, he a freaky ass nigga, he a 69 god. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 god. Hey, 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 run for your life. Hey, 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 run for your life. Freaky ass nigga, he the 69 God. Freaky ass nigga, he the 69 God. Hey, 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 run for your life. Hey, 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 run for
Let
your life.
Let me hear you say O-V-ho.
O-V-ho.
Say O-V-ho.
O-V-ho.
Then step this way. Step that way. Then step this way. Step that way. Are you my friend? Are we locked in? Then step this way. Step that way. Then step this way. Step that way.